Welcome to Tekzilla Bytes, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and I gotta say it, I love a new version of Windows. Windows 98 and Windows 7, awesome. Windows 8, okay. I gotta say, some versions of Windows I've loved a lot less than others, and frankly, some are best forgotten like a drunken night at the Jersey Shore. The money grab that was Windows ME comes to mind, and Vista. Poor, sad little Vista. It's not like there was anything wrong with Vista, but hey, in the Windows world, hope springs eternal, so enter the latest version of Windows, aka the one that will replace 8. Windows 10, technical preview, which you can download and install today. We'll talk about whether or not you should install Windows 10 in a moment. And no, I don't know why Windows 10 is not Windows 9, though rumors are running rampant on the internet, from hardcore programming excuses for not using 9 because of code issues, to Apple fanboy jokes about finally catching up with OS X, to, well, it doesn't really matter. Because Windows 10 technical preview looks a lot like Microsoft has been listening to users. First up, and most obvious, the start menu is back. It's colorful. There are live tiles, but you can move them around, resize the whole thing, and best of all, universal search. Okay, I might be a little overexcited about universal search. It's the old Windows start menu search with web results added in. I kind of really like it. Now, remember modern apps, the big full screen or nothing apps in the style formerly known as Metro? In 10, you can run them in Windows on the desktop. You can also now call them universal apps. Microsoft embracing the desktop is a good start, but Microsoft embracing one of the best things in Linux and OS X is even more awesome. I'm talking about multiple desktops here. OS X users know these as spaces. So you can keep, say, your work and your home workspaces oh so separate and just move back and forth. I'm also liking Task View, which pops up all your open windows. And did I mention Linux? Linux makes me think of rocking the command line, which oddly enough has me thinking about Windows 10. Props to the crew at Lifehacker for uncovering this little gem. You can now, quote, paste a directory into the command prompt with Control V instead of right-clicking, which you currently have to do, which, if you've ever spent a lot of time poking around the command line, is really, really awesome. Microsoft, listen to Lifehacker and add more new features in the command line before you ship 10. I'm just asking nicely. Speaking of listening, I love lynda.com/Tekzilla. They're a sponsor, but they're a place to go to learn video tutorials and everything from the latest Photoshop tricks to video editing to learning how to program. It is an incredible 24-hour a day at your own pace kind of learning situation. And you can get on board for just $25 a month. Unlimited learning at your own pace any time of day. lynda.com/Tekzilla. Go check it out. In any case, backing away from the keyboard and into the 21st century, there's a reason Microsoft is now calling them universal apps. Think apps that will run on the desktop, laptop, tablets, two-in-ones, the kind of laptop that turns into a tablet, and yes, Windows Phone, which is why Microsoft dropped Continuum into Windows 10. We haven't had a chance to test it much yet, but the idea that Windows will know if you've got your laptop flipped around in tablet mode or the Surface out of the keyboard dock sounds stupid useful, especially since they want to do things like put back buttons on the screen when you don't have a back button on a keyboard to use. Awesome. I've only been running it for a day or two, but so far Windows 10 has been rock solid, which isn't much of a surprise. The Windows 8 previews were pretty solid, though Microsoft says touchscreen features in 10 are going to be a little rough for a bit. And like any beta operating system, things can go horrendously wrong. That's why Microsoft recommends, quote, that you don't install the preview on your primary home or business PC, because unexpected PC crashes could damage or even delete your files. So you should back up everything, end quote. Let me be blunt. If you only has one PC, and you can't work or graduate without it, or your kids can't do homework if it's busted, you might not want to replace your current OS with Windows 10. And hey, no matter what OS you're running, if you like your current OS install and you don't want to reinstall from scratch, if you decide you don't like Windows 10, back up your data and clone your drive, because once you've installed this Windows technical preview, you can't uninstall it, unless of course you have a clone of your install ready to reinstall, which you're gonna do because we teach you how to do it in step-by-step Windows drive cloning and SSD optimization, which you can find right here on YouTube, or just go to tekzilla.com and search for drive cloning. So, where do you get Windows 10? Insider.windows.com. You'll need to create a Microsoft account if you don't have one, then you can download an installer or the entire 3.8 gigabyte ISO file that you can run from a USB drive or burn to a disk. Let us know what you think of OS 10 in the comments or email tekzilla@revision3.com. I'm Patrick Norton. Thanks for watching this episode of Tekzilla Bytes, and have yourself a great day.